Hello, and welcome to another episode of Quan 3217. Tonight we will again be doing a RISC-V emulator in Python. And one of the reasons that we're doing this is because of this little goodie over here, godbolt.org. This is named after Matt Godbolt. So no blasphemy intended. And the compiler explorer is, you type in a piece of code on the one side, and it runs it through one of an almost infinite variety of compilers, and it shows you exactly what machine code is generated. So for instance, we got a really simple C program over here, and it generates a bunch of other stuff, but the really important stuff here is right here. So we load the A0 register with the value 42, and then we return. So, another interesting thing is that up here above each one, we've got the actual machine language. So if we come down here, and we try to, we go 0x0200513, we go and we parse this and interpret it, it should break down into an LIA042 instruction. So, let's see, where we last left off, we were doing a little bit of refactoring, and I'm going to do that the whole time that I'm working on this. And it's not even there yet, so we got a bunch of to-dos left, we got some sign extension, all this blah, 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 sign and unsign thingy. And so, where we were is we got a parse instruction here, and it's currently a data class. I'm not sure we're going to leave it as a data class. We got opcode num, and we got undefined up here about. We've got all of these instructions defined, and that's all fine and good. Blah 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 blah. Loading up the instruction map. So what do we have that can actually parse some instruction right now? Well, let's find out. So what we're going to do is we're going to print this. So we'll take this nice little machine language thing here. And one of the things that I know about this, I happen to know, is that that one is an alias. So let's see. Well, that doesn't help at all. There we go, pseudo instruction, That's what we want. So, it looks like what they got going on here is that pseudo instruction is, like, for instance, if you want to load a value into a register, well, there's not really a move move immediate in this instruction set. And what they do instead is they say, well, you take, you have to take a register, but then you can take an immediate and you add them together and then stuff them into a destination register. Well, what if the register that you're adding is zero? You got zero plus your immediate equals, let's see, table, okay, instructions, keep going, where's the, okay, here we go. Load immediate. So, for instance, you could do some, we don't know how they've compiled it yet, but you can do something like, if you want to load R0 with value, instead you load R0 with, or you want to load R12 with a value, you say load R12 with R0 plus your value. So let's see what this has evaluated out to. Run it. Of course, I'm going to do that right. Okay, so we got a parse instruction here with an output of none. That doesn't sound right. Okay. Step in. Well, there's your problem. There you go. So it's opcode 19, RD is 10, so opcode 19. Well, 19 in decimal. That's not really going to do a lot for us, is it? Okay. So opcode 19. So I remember that there was a preprinter, but we're not going to worry about that. So, but anyway, I know that 19 is a in a hex, it's 1-3, which means it's got a bit of 4, and then so 19. Going to do now is we're going to have a look at just making a custom, let's see, where do you put a heart, let's see, there it is. So we're going to put in a, we're going to put in this little, yeah, we'll add the other fields, so, yeah, whatever. Give me a break. That's why we have compilers. There we go. Okay. We can work with that. Okay. printing that one in binary because all the tables are in binary. We're going to print the register numbers in decimal because they're listed in the documentation as in decimal. So what else we got? Point three. And this one's listed in binary, and it's going to be a 3-bit binary. Let's see how we're doing so far. Yay! Okay. Because that's going to get annoying. What else we got? An RS1, RS2, point 7, and immediate. Should probably print it as hex and then and again as decimal and again it's unsigned and again it's signed. We'll worry about all of that later. For now we're just going to leave it as some. Don't like the D, huh? Well, I guess it's not the default. I just won't worry about it. There we go. So then we can say this is where things are going to start getting interesting. Anyway, the first thing we can verify is we got a 001, 001. 1-1. We got to add I. And then 0.3 is 0. So yes, this is an add I. And what it's doing is it's adding register. We actually have to parse the rest of it. So we can do it like that. Oh, wow. Why don't you just work like you're supposed to, you stupid program? Three. Well, that's kind of interesting. Okay, so none is a good idea until you get these special cases like this. So, 3, RS1. Is anyone out there? One viewer. Is that one viewer other than me? If you're out there, speak up. If you're out there, type something in chat. Okay, pressing onward. RS2, 27. I totally remember seeing on another YouTuber that there's some way to stick something on these fields up here where it's something like, and then equals blah 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 percent B or whatever it is. And that would be awesome, but I don't know how to do it. Okay, so it says 01, 001, it's like we said, and point 3 is 0, so then RS1 is 0, RS2 is none, like expected, immediate is 2, which is not really what I expected. We'll get back to that in a moment. Let's have a look at this instruction here. So we got a da da da. So we got 0, 2, A, 0, 5, 1, 3. It's counting with Quan. Fields here. So I got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay. So we're just going to copy and paste you. one. This guy is 23. This guy's out here. Yeah, I missed some widgets. And I'm back. I need a pause button like these other streamers. Let's see. Can I even do that? Sub streaming, yeah, I'm sure if there's something fancy that I can do that would make it work, but yeah, we forgot some things here. I had to go figure out what my cats knocked down. Turned out it was the had my weed whacker standing up down in the sunroom. So we got an RS1, which is 5 digits, and we got an F3. We got an RD, which is another 5 digits, and then an opcode. So that's exactly what we should be getting. And over here, you'll notice that our 42, you know, you'll get used to seeing this if you watch enough programming on YouTube. Well, that is 42 in binary. So our instruction parser should definitely be doing this right. So let's, the time is now. Let's go find out what's up. So let's step over that, step into that. Opcode, RD, let's see what we got. RD is 10. That's what we expect. 3 is 0. RS1 is 0. RS2 is 2. Yeah, this is breaking it down differently. But that definitely ain't right. Because we're gonna break it down as if it was an R instruction. F7 gets 7 bits. RS2 gets 5 bits. RS1 gets 5 bits. It's 3 bits, RD gets 5 bits, opcode gets 7 bits. So it's not doing that right either. Yeah, nothing should be set yet. That's as expected. So that's as expected. Thought for a moment there might have been two of you out there. And if you're out there, speak up. Let me know. Let me know I'm not just doing this recording so that I can download it and put it on YouTube so no one can watch it there. So, step in. About. So let's step into that. Mass width is 5. Give us a print of that. True, huh? Okay, yeah, that doesn't And there's 7 left over here, so that looks like that's right. Appears to be a problem. There's your problem. Yep. Ha! Fix things real pretty darn quick. Let's see if we got that right. So we got opcode, RD, 43, media, 42. So we gotcha. Gotcha all nice and parsed. Now. Opcode p.3 p.7. Do you see the problem here, class? Yeah. That's going to be an issue. Yep, there's your problem. Well, I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna be a little bit more parsimonious with our steps. Wait a minute. This is where we're gonna be parsimonious. So we're gonna say, and then we're gonna say, the off road, and then I hate doing chains of ifs like this, but back to that in a moment. So we're going to use a wonderful feature of Python where you can put a list inside of a list inside of a list, literally. Or you can put a list next to a scalar. In this case, that's what we're doing. We're going to have some elements of our list be a function pointer and some elements of our list be a list of function pointers. And some elements of our list are going to be lists of function pointers, and they're all going to live next to each other, all happy and content, and life will be good. Maybe if I'm loud enough, the algorithm will hear me, and they'll start sending people to my channel. So, what have we done wrong, class? Okay, so first off, this guy is instruction exec 4. And that itself is a list, and so we got one. And it already got add I stuff into it. And how in the world did that happen? Because that's not what we told it to do up here. Okay, so let's look through all these. None of these are so. Okay. Gotta do what you gotta do. Yeah, I know I wrote it. I should understand it perfectly myself. But you know what? I use the debugger to understand my code. I use a tool. We are a tool using species. So now we're going to start loading up code number 4. Now I remember one other problem that I had, so we'll get back to that in a moment. So code number 4 is still a list. How did you already get to the list? Because none of you Well, I guess we've got to be more careful in watching this. Can you tear off this thing into its own? Yes, of course we can. Cool. And we can make you bigger. So all of these are lists now, so opcode 4. All of these are lists. So load these things up. Okay, you. That's not what I expected. Let's do it again. Let's see if it happens again. Okay, 13, that's fine, yep. 5 again, that's fine. And then you are the 16, 8, 24, 26, 27. That's what I expect. Now these guys have been set yet. So now you should be 16, 8, 24, 25. And that's not what I expected to see. These things both. Oh, I bet there's something wrong with this. Yep, that's what happened. Yep, when we built up our original instruction table here, we got 32 copies of the same, 32 references to the same list. So how are we going to fix that? My cat is sitting on the desk staring at me saying, I don't know how to fix it. Do I look like a teddy bear? Happening up here. So we got one length list of a reference to undefined, and that's fine. Multiply it by 128 means we have 128 references to undefined, which is also fine. And why are we doing it like that? So first off, we got that, and that's fine. And then we have a list of 128 references. We got a list, and we're going to build up a list of 128 references to undefined here, and that's fine. And then we're going to have a list comprehension that's going to run this thing 8 times, so we should get 8 independent lists. And then we're going to go list comprehension for the win? Let's find out. So. Now, if these are different, then we win. And they are! Woo! Okay. So. So now if we go over here, because we're going to be looking at inside of this one. Now we've got list number 4, function code 1, which is still a list. And it's still going to get undefined because we haven't defined this one yet. So now this interpret here. Down to 2. So 1-1 down at the end, as we will see later, indicates the compact, the C instruction set. The C is for compact, so that's good enough for me. There's apologies to all of my 0 viewers out there. So it's going to be the next step, so let's do that. Now we're going to interpret. So our instruction is going to be going to go look up instruction set based on this. Start mumbling. Viewers don't like the mumbling. And instruction is still a list, so we're going to keep digging into the list. So we go check out front 3. Which is going to be a 0, and that's going to not give us a list. That's going to give us straight to the add I function. So now instruction is a function, so now we go step into that, and that should step into our add I. Ta-da! Fail. Fail. You know why we failed? Because we've already done this. So we'll do that. And try it again. Well, it did something. We got down to here. So now, art.x, x should be a register file, and it is. And what we should you guys out there screaming at me saying, here's your problem. You fool, why aren't you doing it right? So we're using get and set when we should be using get item and set item. Because get and set is like for doing thing dot stuff, foo dot bar. You use get item for foo bracket number. Because I believe it is the case, it's valid to write to the R0, it just doesn't get remembered. We're going to do it like this. So now what happened? Let's see if we run it. We don't even particularly care if it reaches that statement, we just want to be able to. So we're going to step in, and this should work. Maybe it worked. What did I do with my register, with my variable? Did you do something? Did you break it? It's still running. Okay, well, let's see what happens. None of them are 42. get our zero. That's going to be a zero. And then return volume. And now we should go to the setter. So we're going to set that zero. Yep, that's the problem. Let's see how many of the rest of these have the same issue. And that one's good. That one's fine. That one's fine. That one's fine. So I'll come back here to the setter, put a breakpoint in it. Now we're in the setter, so we're going to set register 10 with value 42. Da-da-da-da. Yay! As expected, okay. So, we have executed an instruction. Let's go see what our next instruction is. Return. One, two, three, four, eight, zero, six, seven. Starting to get an instruction cycle here. Of course not. Because that would be silly. Undefined instruction. Okay. Opcode 11001. 11001. O30B. Jump and leap with a register. And it's not going to work anyway because, yeah. So return, it's jump and leap with RS, with the source. Well, let's go see what it does. That might be the next one we write. Jump to register. Jump to... Okay, so p.i. target address is obtained by adding the sign extended 12-bit I register to the register RS1 and setting the least significant bit to 0. So set the least significant bit to 0 by keeping all of the other bits. The address of the instruction following the jump. So the current PC++4 is written to register RD. I'm going to do this all out explicit so that you can debug the individual values. Because I know that that signed one is going to cause trouble here in a minute. And there you go. Mom, I'm programming. Let's see if this transition thing works. Waiting, waiting, waiting. Here it goes. That is quite a long delay. And we're back. Okay, so let's just say find instruction handles. And then, JLR is not defined. What do you mean not defined? It's not defined, dummy. And why is it running about these? Where did my heart go? It should. There you go. So this return ends up compiling as a jump and link register. X1 plus 0. Let's go and look at the ADI. Okay, so the ADI name of X1 is RA. Okay, good. So the term says jump and link from RA plus 0. Or go to RA plus 0 and store your useless return value in 0 in the bit bucket. And there we go. Yep, code. Want to do anything more interesting? Let's see what we can do that's more interesting. What if we try and get a RISC-V compiler installed? Okay, it was worth a try, but we don't have a claim for Ubuntu. So Ubuntu claim this guy. No peeking in my password. Yeah, one of my crazy ideas is I've got another project which is implemented in C++, and it would be kind of be cool to compile it in machine language and then run it on this interpreter and get this super duper fast ray tracer running on a super duper slow interpreter. Ta-da! So, yeah, the compiler worked. We got RISC-V, none, embed installed, and we can use that to And there's the source code for our program. There's the machine code for our program. We are going to go ahead and dump this into memory. Shall we? I think we shall. Memory is going to be a empty array. An empty dictionary. So now we can do something like out formatting, thank you. And that's not really the right way to do it. That's extra not the right way to do it. But it will work for now. What have we brought? PC 0. definitely going to have to refactor that later. I'm going to use it in our implementation. The PC has already moved on to the next one. There's a console, okay. So, printer. So it's a tab. Immediate. Probably should have, not sure. Probably should have run an error or something. Probably should have said, hey, you hit the unimplemented case. But I didn't. Gave us some space on the stack. So now we're interpreting SSW again, which is going to fail. Undefined instruction store word. Load and store instructions. Aha, they tricked us. They tricked us. Let's go ahead and have a look at it. This is not really so many different ones. Thank you. This is different. Some S type. Now, do we have an S type yet? Base. So I'm just going to call that offset. Let's do that up here. Let's do that up here. And let's do that up here. We did not do that up here. We're going to do better with this now. Thank you. this is where we write the menu. This is from the point of view of the processor, and I don't think that the memory cares. I think that the memory will see a load as still being get a value from memory and store it, put a value in memory. Don't like. Thank you. Yeah, that'll be fine. Okay, so what I was reading about was that you store a word, half word, or byte in the little bits of the given register from the register R0. Well, see, our store doesn't care. It doesn't care how many bits this has. Sorry I'm being quiet here. It's hard to type and think at the same time. This is why I'm not typing right now. So what I got going on here is I'm doing a dump routine which is going to print the hex digits, and then it's going to be the same old dump that you see everywhere. It's going to be very similar to this, except I'm going to do There we go. Okay. So we're gonna net that 010113. So sorry, man. So it's 0163. 01 010413. 02 80 07 93. Am I boring anyone to death out there? No. And that should be in all equals, of course. To return it. You fail to return, you return to fail. How many of these are had I? Okay, well, I'm going to say goodnight, and we'll pick this back up another day.